On the roof of the Basilica of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church celebrates Easter night. This is indeed one of the most beautiful and meaningful of all the Easter celebrations in Jerusalem. Symbolizing the light of the resurrection, the holy fire shines brightly into the night from the roof of the basilica, after being brought up from the empty tomb of Christ. The Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo Church, a title that refers to Christ's one united nature, is counted among the so-called Oriental and non-Chalcedonian churches.
Ethiopian church, spiritual church, and it has different songs, spiritual songs. And
characterized by genuine devotion and a colorful variety of practices, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church is unique in retaining several Jewish customs, such as circumcision, adherence to dietary laws, and Sabbath observance on Saturday as well as Sunday, although more emphasis is laid upon Sunday. This is probably due to the fact that Christianity reached Ethiopia directly from Jerusalem in a form that was still strongly influenced by its Jewish roots. It also appears that Judaism was practiced by some Ethiopians even before Christianity arrived in their country. According to the Ethiopian tradition reported in the Kebre Negest book, the links between Ethiopia and the Holy Land go back to the times of King Solomon. Queen Makeda of Sheba is said to have visited King Solomon in Jerusalem and later to have given birth to his son, Menelik. When Menelik grew up, he visited his father in Jerusalem and returned with the Ark of the Covenant, which he had obtained by subterfuge. From that time until the present, Judaism has been practiced in Ethiopia. It is said that the Chapel of the Tablet in the Church of Our Lady Mary of Zion in Aksum, Ethiopia, still houses the original Ark of the Covenant. St. John Chrysostom mentions that Ethiopians were present in the Holy City on the day of the first Pentecost. Ethiopian tradition affirms that the Holy Sepulchre was erected, at least in part, on a piece of land offered by King Solomon to the Queen of Sheba. This underlies the claim of the Ethiopian Church to the Ethiopian monastery of Deir Sultan on the basilica's roof, and formerly to the Chapel of St. Elena, now the property of the Armenian Orthodox Church. The presence of Ethiopian monks and the existence of Ethiopian properties in Jerusalem can be traced in historical sources to the early Christian centuries and continues throughout the times of the Muslim conquest, the Crusaders, and Salah ad-Din, and on up to the 14th and 15th centuries, when most of their properties in Jerusalem were lost. According to Ethiopian tradition, the royal official of Queen Candace, whose baptism by Philip the Evangelist is related in chapter 8 of the Acts of the Apostles, returned home and evangelized his people. However, Orthodox Christianity did not become the established church of the Ethiopian Aksumite kingdom until the reign of King Ezana, shortly after the Nicene Council in 325. This followed the conversion of Emperor Ezana by a Greek Syrian named Frumentius, who was later appointed Bishop of Ethiopia by Saint Athanasius, Patriarch of Alexandria. From then on until 1959, the Patriarch of all Africa, whose seat remained in Alexandria, always named an Egyptian Copt to be the Abuna, or Archbishop, of the Ethiopian Church. Around the year 480, nine saints, fleeing persecution by Byzantium, in the wake of the Council of Chalcedon in 451, began missionary activities in Ethiopia. Monasteries quickly sprang up throughout the country. Liturgy, art, architecture flourished. To this period is also attributed the creation of Ethiopian church music by a local scholar and disciple of the nine saints called Yared. The Ethiopian church reached its zenith between the 12th and 15th centuries when, following a vision he had, King Lalibela built a new Jerusalem in his kingdom of Ethiopia. After a period of struggle against the Sultanate of Aden, in which the Ethiopians received Portuguese help to oppose the advance of the Ottoman Empire, the Roman Catholic Church sent Jesuit missionaries, such as João Núñez Barreto and André de Oviedo, to gain the Ethiopian king's adherence to Rome. Emperor Susenyos made Roman Catholicism the state religion, but was met with heavy resistance from his subjects and had to abdicate in 1632. He gave the throne to his son, Fasildes, who promptly restored Ethiopian Orthodox Christianity as the official religion. In 1948, an agreement with the Coptic Church made the Ethiopian Church autocephalous, and in 1959, the first Patriarch of Ethiopia was crowned. The Ethiopian Orthodox Church claims more than 50 million members worldwide, including about half the population of Ethiopia. A small Ethiopian Orthodox diaspora is present in the United States, Canada, Australia, the UK and Western Europe, as well as in Latin America, the Caribbean and West Indies. In recent years, the Ethiopian Church has assumed an active role in Ethiopia, especially in sponsoring orphanages and relief efforts for refugees and victims of drought. In the Holy Land, the presence of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church has been maintained mainly through its strong tradition of monasteries.
We have small chapels in the Holy Sepulchre, Del Sultan, as you know. We are serving there. And the largest monastery is this one. This one. And we have also in other places, in Bethlehem, in Bethany, in Jericho, and in the Jordan River, But it is now out of order. And we have seven monasteries in general in Jerusalem and outside Jerusalem.
Resident parishioners, in contrast, are few, and most of its lay members are temporary workers in the Holy Land. Ethiopian Orthodox communities here usually worship by participating in the spiritual life of the monasteries. Philippos Monastery in the Old City of Jerusalem is the seat of Abba Matthias, Archbishop of the Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo Church in the Holy Land. Al-Azariya Monastery in Bethany hosts the older monks, priests and bishops who have given their lives to serve in the Holy Land and at the holy places. Typically, they wear colorful African garments over their monastic clothing. The oldest one is 97 years old. When asked to say a few words, all the monks are unanimous in saying, "We thank God for everything, that he has allowed us to get to our age. We serve the church all our life, and we are very happy here. We always pray for the peace of the world." The Church of St. Tekla Haimanot at the Al-Azariya Monastery is decorated with typical Ethiopian frescoes representing biblical scenes and saints, although the structure of this church is not at all typical. Normally, Ethiopian churches imitate the structure of Hebrew sanctuaries. They consist of a Holy of Holies, or Makdes, where a small reproduction of the Ark of the Covenant, or Tabot, is kept, and only priests may enter. Then there is the nave, Kadist, where communion is administered to the people, and outside the nave is the ambulatory, Kene Mahelet, where the cantors and worshippers stand and sing hymns. Shoes are removed when entering a church, in accordance with the command given to Moses in Exodus chapter 3, verse 5. Deir Sultan Monastery, which means the place of the king, is located on the roof of the Basilica of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem. Because of the special status of this holy site, which does not allow for renovation work, living conditions here are particularly austere. Between the small and rudimentary monastic cells, the monks talk after the evening prayer. In the refectory, below the cupola of the Holy Sepulchre, they share their evening meal, made out of typical African dishes. The monks of Deir Sultan officiate at the two Ethiopian Orthodox chapels in the Basilica. The upper one is dedicated to the Redeemer and to the four animals, representing the four evangelists, and the lower one to Saint Michael the Archangel, protector of the church. Richly ornamented books are used for the Vespers, which is mainly sung, as are all services. To help them stand throughout the long prayer services, the monks use the so-called prayer sticks, called mekwamia. Traditionally, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church runs Sunday schools, where children take catechism, sing together, learn about Ethiopian history and culture, and study Amharic, the current Ethiopian language. Sunday school children also sing special hymns in the church services and participate in special celebrations, like the days of preparation for the Feast of the Assumption of the Virgin Mary, held at the end of August. The great feasts of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church include Christmas, when the Archbishop of the Ethiopian Church solemnly enters the Basilica of the Nativity in Bethlehem, dressed and adorned in colorful liturgical garments. At the end of January is the Feast of Epiphany, or Timket, when the Ark of the Covenant kept in each church is carried around outside in an elaborate procession with joyful songs and dance. Then there is Easter, whose celebrations start with the solemn procession of Palm Sunday, held in Jerusalem on the roof of the Basilica of the Holy Sepulchre, with a traditional waving of palm leaves in honor of the Son of David. Another of the great annual feasts is the Exaltation of the Holy Cross in September. The Christians of Ethiopia make frequent and numerous pilgrimages to the holy places in Jerusalem, the symbol for the heavenly Jerusalem. Formerly, vast numbers of pilgrims would visit the holy shrines, making frequent halts along the way for divine services.
The Ethiopian pilgrim came from Ethiopia through Sudan and Egypt on foot.
Among the celebrated centers of pilgrimage in Ethiopia is the Church of Zion at Aksum, the oldest in the country. Inspired from the Liturgy of St. Mark, the Ethiopian liturgy is of Alexandrian Coptic origin, with influence from the Syriac tradition. Strict adherence to the ancient Ge'ez liturgical language, used since the 4th century, is observed. In Ethiopia and elsewhere, modern Amharic is increasingly being used in the liturgy, as well as for the sermons. As in all Orthodox churches, the Ethiopian liturgy of the Mass is divided into the Ordo Communis and the solemn Eucharistic part, called the Anaphora. The central point of the Anaphora is the great oblation or consecration, called Malawot, that is, change. The bread for consecration is brought from Bethlehem, the name for the place where wine and bread for the Mass are prepared. As in the Western Rite, the central part of the service, the Anaphora, is variable, while the common liturgical framework, the Ordo Communis, remains invariable. There are 14 official versions of the Anaphora in the Ethiopian Church. The weekly services constitute only a small part of an Ethiopian Orthodox Christian's religious observance. Several of the feast days involve prolonged services, followed by singing, dancing, and feasting. The clergy and the very devout observe the full schedule of fasts, which total 250 days per year. In principle, the laity is also expected to fast 250 days, including every Wednesday and Friday, as well as the 2 months composing the Lent and the Easter seasons. Only those who feel pure, having fasted regularly, and have generally conducted themselves properly, may enter the nave of the church to take communion. Usually, most parish members remain in the ambulatory, where cantors sing hymns and dance. In addition to standard feast days, most Ethiopian Christians observe saints' days, and 2 or 3 times a year they honor the patron saint of their parish church. The Ethiopian Orthodox Church has a very strong sense for mystery. Consecration, for example, is so holy that worshippers avoid naming it in order to preserve its great mystery. The Ethiopian Church is very devoted to the Virgin Mary, to the archangels Gabriel and Michael, and to Saint George, all of whom are considered her patrons.
We, as Christians, we believe in Jesus Christ, especially in His Mother, Our Lady, the Mother of Jesus Christ, Mariam. We celebrate, we love Mary, and celebrate her as He is, as her Son, Jesus Christ.
Mary, the Mother of God, has a very special place in Ethiopian devotion, as she holds the highest place after God, or Eksi Abiher in Amharic. Ethiopia is known as the country of Mary, for she is the nation's protectress, her star in peace and war. She is constantly referred to in the liturgy, especially with the prayer of Hail Mary, which is always associated with the Lord's Prayer. It is recited at the beginning and at the end of the Holy Mass, and of most prayer services, and there is also a special prayer to Mary after the reading of the Acts of the Apostles. She is commemorated every month, and there are more than 30 feasts in honor of Mary during the year. The veneration of icons, or rather the holy persons whom they represent, is an important part of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church tradition. Flat, two-dimensional icons are venerated. Offerings of incense and light are given to the figure of the cross, to the holy books of the Gospels, and to other sacred objects in order to give honor to the person represented. Ethiopian church music, called dekwa, is most expressive. The music is adapted to the season of the ecclesiastical year and to the solemnity of the feast. For the joyful feasts, it is grand and exultant. But in seasons of penitence and for the services for the dead, it is mournful. Adoration, thanksgiving, supplication, sorrow, joy and triumph are all represented in the zema or tone of church music. Apart from her strong historical connection with the Coptic Church and her fleeting relations with the Roman Catholic Church, the Ethiopian Church has had special links to the other non-Chalcedonian churches, such as the Armenian and Syrian Orthodox churches, which have influenced and interacted with her traditions in various ways. Nowadays, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church in Jerusalem is open to ecumenism. She is happy to welcome members of other churches, as for example during the Week of Prayer for Christian Unity.
And it is very important to unite with prayer, with worshiping God. It is, God is love, the unity and the peace, and we pray together and for the peace of the world, and the Ethiopian people is very, very happy for that.
Christian unity is considered to be a source of great joy.
I feel very good, because to come together, to pray together, it is important for us and for anyone else, because Jesus said this, to go together, to pray together, to love each other. Therefore, I am very happy, I feel good, very good.
To the other churches, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church is an example of profoundly authentic devotion, of genuine faith, of joyful and strong Christian expression. She gives a precious testimony on the integration of Judaic tradition into the Christian faith, while at the same time being fully integrated into the Christian Orthodox tradition. She is one of Africa's earliest representatives at the holy places in Jerusalem, the mother of all churches.
This is the main source of the churches, and our mission here in Jerusalem is, and the great mission here in Jerusalem, because this is the source of all churches in the world.